Family and friends, we are gathered here today to witness and celebrate the union of Erica Miller and John Boer in marriage. In the years that they have been together, their love and mutual understanding has grown and matured. They have freely chosen to live the rest of their lives together as husband and wife. Who gives this woman to this man in marriage?
Her father and I had that honor this afternoon.
You may be seated.
Jordan.
Erica and John want this ceremony to reflect both of their personalities. Although most of this will sound very familiar, it is written in their words to make it their very own. Knowing they were going to be a little nervous and emotional this evening, they've asked me, who's not nervous at all, to help them be sure to include all that they have gathered us here this evening to say, to us, to the world, and most importantly, to each other. True marriage is more than the legal union of two people. It is the joining of two hearts. It begins well before the wedding day, and the efforts of marriage continue well beyond the ceremony's end. A brief moment in time and the stroke of the pen are all that is required to create the legal bond of marriage. But it takes a lifetime of love, commitment, and compromise to make marriage durable and everlasting. Today, you declare your commitment to each other before family and friends. Your yesterdays were the path to this moment, and your journey to a future of togetherness becomes a little clearer with each new day. May you always be able to talk things over, to confide in one another, to laugh with each other, to enjoy life together, and to share moments of peace and quiet when the day is done. May you be blessed with a lifetime of happiness and a home of warmth, understanding, and love. It is fitting and appropriate that you, the friends and family of Erica and John, be here to witness and participate in their union. For the ideals, the understanding, and the mutual respect which they bring to their life together, derived from the love, friendship, and guidance you have provided them. As you enter into marriage, remember the reasons and experiences that have brought you here, the love you share, the fun that you have had, and realize that in the springtime of your life, you have already found your best friend. May the happiness that you've already found together mature into a lifetime of joy. In the famous words of Mark Twain, to get the full value of joy, you must have someone to divide it with. Erica and John, today you are surrounded by your friends and family, all of whom have gathered here to witness your marriage and to share in the joy of this special occasion. Today, as you join yourselves in marriage, there is a wide and unknown future stretching out before you. The possibilities and potentials of your married life are great. It now falls upon your shoulders the task of choosing your values and making real your dreams. Through your commitment to each other, may you grow and nurture a love that makes both of you better people, a love that continues to give you great joy, and also a passion for living that provides you with energy and patience to face the responsibilities of life. This wedding celebration is a joining of two unique families who stood separate until today. Today, we unite these families by the marriage of Erica and John. They would each like to honor the separateness of their families and now the togetherness with the giving of a rose to their mothers. They would also like to acknowledge the love and sacrifice that each mother has made to make their children who they are today, a man and woman who are ready to be in a committed, loving marriage of their own. Erica and John have also asked that we take a moment to honor those who are not with us today. As you look at the familiar faces around you, please take a moment of silence for those who are near to us in spirit. Now the time has come to forget all the stress that led up to this day. And remember that you are surrounded by family and friends who all came here in the support of two of you. Turn and face one another, please. I want you two to look at each other. Really look at each other and soak it all in. Because this is the best that you'll ever look. Tomorrow you will wake up and your hair will be messed up, back in your cardinal sweatpants. Your makeup will be washed off. You'll most likely have cake on your face. And real life starts. So remember how you look today and how much money you're saving by not looking like this every day. Remember also the requests that you have prepared for each other.
John, do you vow to always keep me guessing and challenge me at least once a day?
I do.
Do you vow to fix things when they break, even when you didn't break them?
I do.
Do you vow to bring me a beer when I'm hiding in the bathroom because the Cardinals are down to their last strike and extra innings during a World Series elimination game?
I do. Erica, do you vow to make sure you're not just hungry before you try to pick a fight with me?
I do.
Erica, do you vow not to hide, donate, or throw away any of my belongings without checking with me first?
Yes, with the exception of your paint-spattered shirt that your mom and I both hate.
Fair enough. Erica, do you vow to not point out my typos except in business letters and resumes?
I do.
We're good here.
Erica, do you take this man to be your husband?
I do.
John, do you take this woman to be your wife?
He does.
Close enough. Please join hands and repeat after me. I, John, take you, Erica, to be my wife.
I, John, take you, Erica, to be my wife.
My partner in life and my one true love.
My partner in life and my one true love.
To love you more each day than I did the day before.
To love you more each day than the day before.
I will trust you and respect you.
I will trust you and respect you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Loving you faithfully through good times and bad.
Loving you faithfully through good times and bad.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
I give you my hand, my heart, and my love.
I give you my hand, my heart, and my love.
From this day forward, for as long as we both shall live.
From this day forward, and as long as we both shall live.
Repeat after me. I, Erica, take you, John, to be my husband.
I, Erica, take you, John, to be my husband.
My partner in life and my one true love.
My partner in life and my one true love.
To love you more each day than I did the day before.
To love you more each day than I did the day before.
I will trust you and respect you.
I will trust you and respect you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Loving you faithfully through good times and bad.
Loving you faithfully through good times and bad.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
I give you my hand, my heart, and my love.
I give you my hand, my heart, and my love.
From this day forward, for as long as we both shall live.
From this day forward, for as long as we both shall live.
Brian and Sarah, may I please have the rings? Erica first. Erica, place this ring on John's hand as you read him your vows.
John, I love you because you like spicy food, which I think makes you just the right mix of sweet and spicy. I love you because you accept my craziness at face value and don't bat an eye when I lock myself in the bathroom until the Cardinals game is over. I love you because you're still standing here marrying me, despite the 18 months of Say Yes to the Dress, My Fair Wedding, and Bridezillas that I DVR'd so that I'd never miss a single episode. Because I love you, I promise to let you teach me how to hang drywall and to do my fair share of the work making our house into a home. I love you because you write me sweet poems for my birthday, for Christmas, and just because. I love you because you constantly try to make me laugh and take a break from my brain, even if we really need to be focused on something, like this wedding. I love you because you'll eat an entire bag of croutons in one sitting, and nothing else, and call that dinner. Because I love you, I promise to celebrate our differences, because I know that our goals are united.
John, place this ring on Erica's finger as you read her your vows.
Erica, I love you because you remind me of all the times I should send greeting cards. Erica, I love you because you always remember to feed the cats. And Erica, I love you because you give yourself the hiccups when I make you laugh too hard. And because I love you, I promise to make you laugh when you are stressed or sad or even just grumpy because you're hungry. Erica, I love you because you always smell wonderful no matter what you think. Erica, I love you because you never eat my leftovers. And I love you because you're willing to help anytime I ask. And because I love you, I promise to keep my random junk in the office and scratch your head at least once a day.
Wedding rings are made precious, not by the metal that they are made of, but by our wearing them. Your rings say that even in your uniqueness, you have chosen to be bound together. Let these rings also be a sign that the love has substance as well as soul, a present as well as a past, and that despite its occasional sorrows, love is a circle of happiness, wonder, and delight. May these rings remind you always of the vows you have taken here today. Please reflect on the promises you have just made to one another as you take turns and your witnesses signing the marriage license. Erica and John, remember to treat yourselves and each other with respect, and remind yourselves often of what brought you together. Take responsibility for making the other feel safe, and give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your connection deserves. When frustration, difficulty, and fear assail your relationship, as they threaten all relationships from time to time, remember to focus on what is right between you and not what is wrong. Family and friends, this is a moment of celebration. Let it also be a moment of dedication. The world does a good job of reminding us of how fragile we are. Individuals are fragile. Relationships are fragile too. Every marriage needs the love, nurture, and support of a network of family and friends. On this wedding day, I ask you not only to be friends of Erica or John, but friends of Erica and John together, friends of the marriage. For your comfort, please remain in your seats after the recessional. Erica and John request to greet each of you personally as you leave the ceremony. And now, by the power vested in me by the state of Missouri and the internet, I hereby pronounce you husband and wife. John?
Yes.
You may kiss your bride.